Got it to Nystrom on right wing. His rising shot went over top of the net. The deal gave Merrick a shot from behind. Merrick with the puck. Back of the Ranger goal. Put it out in front off Nystrom. And it's brought out by Vatney. Vatney fires a long shot. Smith, the glove save, and he holds on. And immediately some pushing and bumping in front of the Islander goal.
At the other end, Jiggs. And the first play, Wayne Merrick takes a hit. Bob Nystrom takes a hit from Petillo and Barry Beck. Rangers have hit hard in the previous two games. I'm sure here at the Madison Square Garden, they're at home, the hits will have a little more sting to them.
Apparently the Rangers were offside. It's impossible to hear the official's whistle. Well, they'll get the faceoff outside the blue line. Petillo is on the right wing. Allison is at center ice, and Don Maloney is on the left side. It's Merrick with Wayne Sutter and Nystrom for the Islanders. Merrick had been knocked down, and Beck fires it around the boards. Denny Potvin chasing it. Petillo will put it out in front of the goal, but right to Merrick. Wayne Merrick got away from one check. Cleared the puck up the right side, held in. Beck with a drive off the stick of Smith. Held in by Petillo. Dumps one around the boards, but Morrow is there. The Nystrom, Vadney on top of him, and now Potvin gets a hit as he clears it into center ice. Merrick racing in, two on one, can't get it over to Sutter as Barry Beck broke up the play.
Fine play by Barry Beck defensively on Wayne Merrick. Merrick has a chance to get it to Dwayne Sutter. Barry Beck gets a stick in front of it, excuse me. Some pushing and shoving again. The spirit of the game is in all of the players. We get a look at the two-on-one break. Denny Potvin gets the puck to Merrick, and as he tries to pass to Sutter, you see him coming in on the screen. Beck sliding out, moving his stick in front of him, broke up the play.
That was Maloney coming back on Sutter for the Rangers. The faceoff will be to the right of the net. Al Arbour has set up Ryan Trottier. Mike Bossy is on the right wing, and Clark Gillies is on the left side. Lorimer and Lane, the Islander defense. Duguay on this draw for the New York Rangers. Is Vickers and Talifas on the wings. The puck came to Gillies. The pass intended for Lorimer came outside the line. Then Lorimer is knocked down. Laidlaw shot it high, but the whistle has sounded, and we'll get a faceoff right at the New York Ranger blue line. We're still only a minute and 7 seconds into this opening period. Rangers with Laidlaw and Kotsopoulos together on defense. Lane and Lorimer, the Islander defense, as Trottier moves in for the draw against Duguay. Duguay got scored in the series. Lane, a long shot. Baker, the stick save. Bossy in after the rebound, was checked on the boards. Came loose. Trottier stepped into Kotsopoulos. The puck loose. Bourne with it. Out for the first time. Bourne tied up in the far corner. He's content to force a faceoff in the Rangers zone. Bob Bourne has missed the last four games in the playoffs with that nagging groin injury.
Jiggs, Bob could have played, I understand, in the two games on Long Island against the Rangers, but an injury like a groin is something that you can only aggravate more by playing on it. You extend it. The way Bob Bourne extends his legs in skating, you would only make it worse, so they decided to keep him out.
Bourne right from the faceoff. Drilled one wide of the Ranger goal. Trottier back in the net to Bossy in front all alone, and he backhanded it wide. Kotsopoulos in the corner. Dumps it out into center, and Bourne was back. Bob Bourne to Dave Langevin. Now to McEwen. McEwen to Bossy on right wing. Over the Ranger line. Shoots one. Just went wide on the stick side. Bob Bourne dumps it off in front. Laidlaw picks it up for the Rangers. And on the right side to Talifas. Now to Duguay. Fires a long shot. Smith the pad save, and McEwen clears the rebound. This is Hospodar at center ice. Boxcar with a shot that went over top of the Islander goal. Duguay after the rebound. Vickers heads for the net. Duguay is checked. And Mike McEwen clears it ahead for Butch Goring. Goring to Gillies. Mark Gillies coming in on the right side. Bumped on the boards. Grabbed on the play. And the faceoff coming in the Rangers' zone. There's a break in the action. 17:44 left in the first period. The score, the Islanders nothing, the Rangers nothing.
taste buds for everyone who puts it down in black and white.
This bud's for you. For all you do, the king of beers is coming through.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser. For all you do. This bud's for you.
Play just underway. The Islanders have been forced back. Now Goring gets it across the line to Sutter. Sutter bumped on the play. Here's Morrow at the line. Shooting. Baker the save, and it comes off to the corner. Gillies got a slap in front of the net from Hospodar as Reschner comes over the Islander line. Reschner trying to come in around Potvin. Loose puck. Smith the save. They bang at the rebound, and Billy Smith is covered up and held on.
Billy Smith making the save off the rebound as Hedberg. Rebound from Greschner. Greschner, number four, trying to track around Potvin. Potvin touches the puck. Hedberg takes the shot. Smith made the save. Or Greschner, I should say, took the shot. Hedberg got the rebound, let the shot go, and right into the catching glove of Billy Smith. Good chance at both ends. A moment ago, Mike Bossy, in all alone, missed on a backhand. He missed by quite a bit.
Now Trottier is out for the Islanders with Bossy and Carroll. McEwen and Langevin, the Islander defense. Vadney and Laidlaw together on the Ranger defense. Gillis, Nethery, and Pauline rallying for the Rangers. Look at Clark Gillies, who is reunited with Butch Goring and Dwayne Sutter just a moment ago. And Kevin Collins trying to get them set for this faceoff. Brian Trottier steps in. Collins didn't drop the puck. Now he does, and Trottier plays it across on the right side for Mike Bossy. Bossy around the check, and Nethery almost broke it up. This is McEwen starting out. McEwen to Billy Carroll. Now to Bossy at center ice. Across the line, checked on the play, picks it up again. But they ruled that he brought it in and stayed on the offside. So we'll get a face-off right at the Ranger blue line.
Mike Bossy exercising a displeasure with Bruce Hood. He said, I haven't taken the puck across the blue line yet, and they called it offside. Sometimes linesmen will jump the gun a little bit with their whistle when they anticipate the player taking the puck across the line with one of his teammates already in this case, the Rangers end of the ice. They blow the whistle. Bossy fooled him.
Laidlaw's pass was broken up, brought back into the Rangers zone by Tonelli, who's out along with Kallur and Carroll. The Rangers trying to play it up on the left wing boards. Laidlaw over to Vadney. Out to center. This is Nethery shooting the puck into the Islanders zone. Smith cuts it off back of the net for Mike McEwen. Around to Kallur. He was bumped. Laidlaw from the blue line plays it back of the Islander goal. Langevin is there. Dave Langevin. Dumps one around the boards. McEwen chasing it. Carroll comes over to help out. Billy Carroll. Around to the left wing for Tonelli. John Tonelli to Kallur too far, and the puck is loose. Laidlaw goes back. Rangers change on the fly. Laidlaw gave it to Vadney as Fatio comes out on the right side. Took the pass from Vadney. Fires a long shot. Smith the save. Allison in after the rebound. He's taken to the boards. In comes Billy Carroll for the Islanders. Don Maloney for the Rangers. Maloney dug it loose, put it out in front. It hit Tonelli. Now Allison is checked, and McEwen fed the puck to Kallur. Cleared it off the defenseman Vadney, and the Rangers control it again at center ice. Vadney shot it in. It went over the boards and into the crowd. There's a break in the action. 15:35 left in the first period, and the game is tied. The Islanders nothing, the Rangers nothing.
You've got to be tough to be number one. Real tough. And good. Real good. Good like the Chevy Chevette at your Nassau stop at Chevy dealers. It's America's best-selling small car. A solid performer for 5 years. You get a Chevette, and you get dependability and economy. Bank on it. So, look before you import. See the Chevette at your Nassau stop at Chevy dealers. Number one on Long Island.
Neither team, Jiggs, has been able to dominate the play so far. It's been pretty even back and forth. A lot of play at center ice. Close checking is the reason for the play at center ice.
Rangers have been credited with five shots on goal. The Islanders won to this stage. Bossy hooked the puck loose at center, but Fatio plays one off the boards right to Lane. Allison tying up Lane. Fatio comes over as well, and we'll get a faceoff outside the Ranger line. The same two teams. Game four is on Tuesday night here at Madison Square Garden. And we'll be on hand with the action here on Sports Channel beginning at 8:30 Eastern Time. Nice to be able to say Eastern Daylight Time, isn't it?
It sure is. Can't get used to yet coming out of the house and it not being dark, going to a hockey game.
Gordy Lane back in his own zone. Gillies has come out on this line with Trottier and Bossy now. But the Islanders have cleared at the length of the ice. And the faceoff comes all the way back, of course.
Still waiting, Jiggs, in a way for the Rangers to really bust things open for themselves. They have not been successful at playing the way they did on Long Island. I would think that being back home, they have a better feeling. They have not lost here in the playoffs yet. And the reason they've been successful is that they skate and check the other team. Apparently against St. Louis, they were tenacious in forechecking. They put a lot of pressure on St. Louis's defense and made them cough up the puck and were successful. I would think that they would try and start to do that any time, or I would have thought they would have started right from the beginning of the game.
The pressure really is on the Rangers, and Duque is just taking a tripping penalty. He upended Gordy Lane as he went back of the net. The Rangers aren't going to be able to do that and win this series. They can play every game at home. There's a break in the action with the score. The Islanders nothing, the Rangers nothing.
I fought a battle here and lost. When Congress wanted to deregulate the airlines, I wasn't sure Eastern could survive. I was wrong because I underestimated the people of Eastern. They worked hard to get you to fly us, and now we're flying to new cities, buying new planes, building new terminals. For the past 2 years, more people have chosen to fly Eastern than any other airline in the free world. If we want you to keep flying Eastern, and we do, we have to earn our wings every day.
A tripping penalty to Ron Duque, not considered a good penalty at all. Jiggs McDonald, as Duque draws the first penalty of the game, right here. You see him pulling the feet out from underneath Gordy Lane. No reason in the offensive zone to be getting a tripping penalty such as that. This is the thing that could hurt them the most if they take foolish penalties.
So the Islanders on the power play, as you see the stats, I don't have to say that it has been excellent. Although not as good in this series as it was earlier. Bossy into the Rangers zone. Trying to put one out in front. It hit the defenseman. Gillies got it back to Bossy. Here's Potvin with a shot. That was blocked as Gillies dove in front of it. The puck went up into the crowd.
Fine defensive move by number six, Jerry Gillies. Mike Bossy catches Dennis Potvin coming in from his left point position. Potvin takes the puck and lets it go all in one motion. Gillies, good position for a penalty killer as the forward. Making a sliding move, blocking the shot. The puck hit Gillies, bounced over the glass. Another thing, the glass has been raised at all points around the rink here in Madison Square Garden. At least I did not recognize it as being that high all the way around the building the last time we were here. Generally on the ends, it's much higher than it is on the sides, not so. They have raised it all the way around.
Yeah, you're right, 18. The puck has been cleared. Denny Potvin back for the Islanders. Gave it to McEwen. McEwen back to Potvin into center ice. Dennis to the Ranger line. Gillies heads in on the right wing. The pass broken up. Beck failed to clear it on the first attempt. And now Vadney is stumped at the length of the ice. Bob Bourne comes out to replace Gillies. McEwen forechecked in his own zone. It came back to Beck. His drive hit Trottier. Picked up by Bossy. Bossy over the Ranger line, two on one, and Vadney, a dazzling defensive move on Bossy. He had Bourne wide open on the left wing. Now this is McEwen turning for the Islanders. His pass hit Trottier and goes back into the Islanders' zone. Trottier off the boards to Denny Potvin. Rink wide, this is Bossy on the right side. Bossy is checked, the puck went to McEwen, back to Mike Bossy. Bossy to Bourne, around the check of Allison, gave it to Potvin, now to McEwen. McEwen steps in over the line. Bossy picks up the puck. Can't get around Don Maloney. Bourne comes to the boards trying to dig it loose. Can't do so. And we'll get a face-off to the left of Baker with 28 seconds left in Duguay's tripping penalty.
good hustle by the Rangers penalty killers. They've got the Islanders reeling a little. They're not sure. They've been breaking up the Islanders' pattern of coming out of their own end and bringing the power play up through center ice. They've been finding Ranger forwards right on them quickly. They had to hurry their pass, and the pass has not been good. As a penalty killer, that's what you want to do. You want to put pressure on forwards or defensemen carrying the puck out of their own end, make them hurry their play so that they'll make bad passes.
The Rangers have just cleared it the length of the ice. In the Edmonton series, the Islander power play was working at about a 50% ratio. Against the Rangers thus far, 3 of 11 for a 27.3% efficiency rating in the power play. And the Rangers have all but killed off this penalty against Duque as Beck set it off the boards. McEwen with it at his own line. Shot one in around the boards. Baker didn't go out of the net to cut it off. Duque is back on. So the Rangers have killed off the penalty. They've got a 2-on-1 break. Don Maloney with Duque. Maloney's shot. Smith the save, and he holds on. There's a break in the action with the score tied. The New York Islanders nothing. The New York Rangers nothing.
Up, up. A dip in the road. A pothole. Finally, rust. But there is an alternative. Rust preventative with Quiet Ride by UltraSeal. UltraSeal is injected into each unprotected area of your car, guarding against rust, while assuring the most soundproof ride possible. Most important, UltraSeal with Quiet Ride guarantees protection from rust for the lifetime of your car. Don't sentence your car to a dull and rusty life. UltraSeal it. Available only at new car dealers.
Islanders didn't get a shot on their power play, Jake. Bad sign. Good sign for the Rangers. They came out of the box. Duque got the pass to Maloney, and he got a good shot away. Billy Smith made the save.
Now Merrick on this draw for the Islanders. He's out with Nystrom. Trottier was there as well, and as the Islanders move to center, Nystrom shoots one in. Baker the save. Tonelli comes on to replace Brian Trottier. Tonelli on the left wing side. Nielsen to Greschner across the Islander line. Poked off his stick by Lorimer. Bob Lorimer takes a look. Long pass up the right wing. Nystrom poked it around Laidlaw. Back came Katsopoulos. Katsopoulos uses the boards to play it into center. Lane to Tonelli. Tonelli's long shot steered aside by Baker, and it's picked up by Laidlaw. Merrick in forechecking. Tonelli in on the left side as well. As Laidlaw comes out on the left wing. Into center ice to Greschner. Greschner shot it in around the boards. Billy Smith out of the net, plays it to the left wing, out of the reach of Tonelli. Katsopoulos, Hospodar rather, with a shot, and that was blocked. Here's Nystrom sending Tonelli across the Ranger line. John Tonelli around Laidlaw, centered right through the goal mouth. Comes off the right wing boards for Hedberg. Hedberg over the Islander line with Nielsen. Drop pass to Greschner. Greschner around Merrick. Can't get the shot away as Nystrom stepped in front of him. Smith dives out. Can't smother the puck, but the Islanders have been able to clear it to safety, forcing the Rangers to go back. Both teams changing on the fly. This is Hospodar shooting one in over the line, cleared out of there by Langevin. He and Morrow teamed up on the Islander defense. Kallur, Bourne, and Carroll up front for the Islanders. Islanders have shot it down into the Rangers zone, just over the goal line. Hospodar back to pick it up. That's icing with 11:21 remaining. Period number one. Billy Carroll and Hospodar having some words.
Hospodar had been giving Carroll the stick. Carroll checked Hospodar right in front of the Ranger bench. Hospodar gave him a little bit of a shove back. That's the aftermath of that. Jiggs, something that we just found out. Baker, Steve Baker, the goaltender for the New York Rangers, was late getting out onto the ice for the warm-up. And you could hear the fans cheer when he finally stepped on the ice after everybody else was out skating around. He came out late. We understand that he got caught in a tremendous traffic jam on his way to the Madison Square Garden Arena, and that's the reason he was late.
I'd heard that the pads and the skates were going to be late arriving, that there had been a truck fire apparently on 95 somewhere. I didn't realize he was involved. Well, out in that jam at least.
All right, I may have got it wrong when I thought he was late. I guess it's the equipment.
Well, he may have been too. In any event, he was late getting out on the ice.
Easy to be late getting to Madison Square Garden.
Yes, I'm sure. Jerry Gillis firing the puck into the Islanders' zone. Smith left it for Langevin. Around to the left side, that's Bob Bourne. Can't stick handle around the check. The puck came right to Kallur. Dropped it back, Brian Trottier into center ice. Trottier sends Kallur over the line. Kallur turning back to the blue line. Morrow with a shot. Baker the save, and he dropped it off for Beck. Ernie Beck up that far side. Played rink wide to Gillis. Out of the reach of Nethery on the return pass. Langevin thought he had cleared it out. Yes, he did. It comes back in offside, and there's no further play. We have 10:31 remaining in the opening period. We've had only the one penalty. Duguay for tripping at 4:54. As we take a look at Carroll Vadney.
Senior member of the New York Rangers, has the most playoff experience, the most experience period. Has had a long and sometimes distinguished career.
Did not endear himself to Islander fans with the shot he gave Billy Carroll in the third period of game two of the series.
Something like that. I don't think you endear yourself to hockey fans in general. That was something that's not called for. I'll bet he wishes he hadn't done it. Maybe he doesn't. I don't know. I don't know him that well. Played with him in Boston for a while, but never got to know him that well.
Over the years in your career, you endeared yourself to the fans. Hey, the cheer you got when you walked through Madison Square Garden tonight.
Oh, yeah. Westfall, why don't you get a transplant in your voice? Why don't you drop dead and a whole lot of other things I can't mention.
There's only one thing, 18. They're listening.
They're involved. Must have been effective. I think they still think of me as a hockey player, unfortunately.
This is Clark Gillies into the Rangers zone. Couldn't get around Vadney. Grabs a hold of Vadney, and Gillies is going to take a penalty. Mark Gillies will get the first Islander penalty of the game as he turned Vadney around in the corner. So the Rangers get a chance to test their power play. There's a break in the action with the score tied. The Islanders nothing, the Rangers nothing.
WHN gives you Crystal Gale.
I've received letters from people wanting me, telling me they've sent my record to a guy or a girl, you know, saying how it really got them back together. And, you know, I like that.
Don't it make my brown eyes? Don't it make my brown eyes? Don't it make my brown eyes blue?
1050 WHN.
Clark Gillies draws the Islanders. First penalty holding. Here he's after Carroll Vadney. Gets a hold of Vadney, but he gets him the wrong way. Gets right arm wrapped around him, reaches out with the left, pulls him one loop around a 360 and goes into the penalty box for his efforts. So the Rangers get a power play opportunity. And the Ranger power play against the Islanders in this series is 2 of 10. That's 20% as compared to just under 18% of the regular season.
Their total for the playoffs is 18.4% efficiency on the power play.
Greshner starting out now ahead for Vickers, broken up by Bourne. It's Bourne and Kallur with Potvin and Morrow, the Islander defense. Hedberg, Vickers, and Nielsen up front for the Rangers. They have Barry Beck and Greshner on the points, and the Islanders have forced them all the way back into their own zone. Barry Beck up the left side to Greshner. Greshner's shot went off a stick, cleared by Billy Carroll, and now comes in offside. Billy Carroll has come out along with Butch Goring.
Look at Barry Beck, who's been having a much better playoff than he has had a regular season. Has been criticized by some as not producing enough as a New York Ranger, highly touted rookie when he was with Colorado Rockies. Seems to be settling in and playing his best hockey at this time.
Beck just dumped the puck into the Islanders zone. Potvin took his man out, now able to clear the puck, but it went to Nielsen. Back to the blue line and broken up by Carroll to Goring. Goring into center, Beck and Greshner back for the Rangers. Goring got it to Carroll. Billy Carroll out to Goring. Goring, the pest, dumps one into the corner and back for his Hedberg. Up the left side to Vickers. Rink wide to Greshner. They come three on three. Greshner over the Islander line. Long shot went wide, but the whistle had sounded an offside anyway.
Rangers having trouble. They're hitting people with legs. They're hitting Islanders on the legs with passes or shots that they're trying to shoot the puck in, like they were at even strength. Hedberg, as we see him go to the bench, was offside on the play that time, forcing the offside as he led his team up the ice. Not a very good sign for the Rangers. The Islanders' power play, not good at all. They did not get a shot so far. The New York Rangers, 43 seconds left in Clark Gillies' penalty. They have not taken a shot at Billy Smith yet. They have not had the puck, really, in the Islanders' end to do so.
True. Allison on this faceoff. The puck came loose. Laidlaw with it at center. That right side, they play it rink wide for Don Maloney. Maloney dumps it around the boards. Smith blocked that, and Lorimer clears it the length of the ice. 28 seconds left of the penalty against Gillies. There's no score in the first period. Laidlaw takes a look, ahead to Maloney. Maloney dumps one into center ice. Dahlin with it, lost control of it. It's cleared by Gordy Lane. And again, the Rangers are going to have to go all the way back.
Puck control is the secret to any power play. Neither team so far has been able to distinguish themselves with good puck control.
This is Vadnais pulling to the left and then offside at the New York Islander line. That came just as Gillies stepped out of the penalty box, so the Rangers and the Islander power play didn't show you very much.
I like to give credit to the penalty killers, of course, Jiggs, but I have to recognize the fact that their power plays were not working well. A little bit because of the defense thrown up by each team, but mostly because they did not pass the puck well. They did not handle the puck well. Islanders like to get the puck inside the other team's blue line and start to work it around. They did not get it inside the Rangers' blue line. The Rangers like to dump it in and go and get it, and they couldn't do that.
The voice of a guy who has killed more than one or two penalties in his career.
Ruined a few power plays I was on, too.
I would never mention that. Nice from a long shot that bounced in front of Baker. He was able to scoop it up. Hospodar missed Fatio with the pass. Here's Duque down the left side. Duque against Langevin. Right wing pass, and Talifas couldn't hold it. Then Langevin stepped into Talifas. Hospodar with a shot that goes wide. Duque chasing it to Talifas in the corner. Dean Talifas turned around on the hit from Merrick. And Wayne Merrick fed it to Nystrom. Into center ice to Tonelli. Over the line, Tonelli trying to come in around Hospodar. He was checked, but Nystrom was there. Bob Nystrom knocked down on the play. Fatio got a piece of him along with Hospodar. Fatio with the puck, ahead for Duque. Duque turning at center ice. All the way back into the Ranger zone to try and get away from Tonelli. Just did, and Tonelli hung right with him. Now Duque over the line to Beck, who missed the pass. The puck is loose for Nystrom. Nystrom, rink wide, off the boards at center. Hospodar being chased again by Tonelli. Now Trottier with it. Left it outside the line for Tonelli. Played one rink wide, broken up by Beck. Beck at the Islander line. Trying to come in on the left side. Trottier got back to hammer Beck with a good body check. And Brian Trottier does it all. Now Langevin in front of his own goal to McEwen, ahead to Trottier. Brian Trottier into center. Fatio turned McEwen around. There'll be a Ranger penalty coming up. The puck loose at the Ranger line, cleared by Bourne. Smith has gone to the bench. The Islanders with the extra man. McEwen to Goring. Goring twisting and turning to get away from Nethery. At left side, it's Langevin now at center. Delayed penalty in effect as Langevin elected to dump one in. Beck goes back for it, takes it to the boards, and the play is called. There's a break in the action with the score tied. The New York Islanders nothing, the New York Rangers nothing. Collegiate baseball returns to Sports Channel this Sunday when the Redmen of St. John's University play host to the Columbia Lions. You can catch that action starting at 4:30 tomorrow afternoon. And then on Monday night at 7, it's Columbia versus the University of Pennsylvania. Don't miss any of the baseball action here on Sports Channel. It's your box seat to New York sports at home.
Fatio, as you get a close-up look at him in the penalty box, Mike McEwen took an elbow from him. Nick Fatio gets the penalty. The Islanders get another opportunity to see if they can't do something more productive than they did the last time they were on the power play.
Bossy got it back to the blue line. That's Bourne to Potvin at the right point. And as Potvin into Trottier, comes right in on goal, shoots Baker the pad save, and the Rangers are able to clear it. Gillies was being bothered in front of the net, had been shoved right into Baker's lap, practically.
Number 24, Chris Katsopoulos, doing a number on Clark Gillies as he tries to get in position in front of the net. Bruce Hood allowing that to go.
Now Gillies' pass is deflected right to Baker. He covers up and holds on.
It's always a fine line, Jakes, in the referee's eyes, or they always take the position. That's Hector Marini, you see, right there, close up next to him. Two down is Bill Torrey,
Jerry Eamon,
Tex Eamon, and Gary Howatt, the Islander players and personnel.
Boy, they got better seats than we did.
Are they the seats that are right behind the bench, I wonder?
That's where they are. Now I'm not so sure that they are better than ours.
I don't, they, a lot of times they sit in the press box, Jake. I'm not sure whether they're behind the bench. We'll have to see if we can't get a good look.
Yeah, they're right behind the bench at the moment, 18.
Okay, thank you.
Here's Bossy to Gillies in the corner. Back to Mike Bossy, cuts in off the wing. Backhanded one and scores! Mike Bossy, and it was deflected off the Rangers in front of the goal. Bad day, I believe, it's the one who...
Mistakes, that's the name of the game. The Rangers make one, the Islanders score. Bossy gets the pass. It's a two-on-one as he goes out to get the puck to Trottier. Vadney puts his stick and glove down to block the pass. It hit his glove and deflected. Baker had left the left side of the net, as you can see, and was moving right laterally across the net. The puck was deflected from whence he had just came. And the Islanders, a power play opportunity, a power play goal, have taken a 1-0 lead.
The goal at 14:36. Now Greschner knocking the puck down, cuts to the right across the Islander line. Can't get around Lane. Smith out of the net. Held in by Hedberg. Kicked it back of the goal. Greschner and Lane again. Here's Nielsen on the boards. Greschner digs it loose. Lane right on top of him. Greschner to Hedberg. He's hooked. There'll be an Islander penalty.
John Tonelli knocks Hedberg down and gets the penalty for it. A break in the action with the score of the New York Islanders 1, the New York Rangers nothing.
WHN gives you Dolly Parton.
People like my songs because they're about real things, and I like to think that they're ordinary stories told in an extraordinary way.
Starting over again. They've never been out on their own.
1050 WHN.
You see John Tonelli, number 27. He gets the penalty on Anders Hedberg, number 15, right there. A hooking penalty, Bruce Hood calls it. Hedberg goes down on the move by John Tonelli. Now the Rangers get a power play opportunity, and the faceoff is in the Islanders' end.
Puck comes back to the line for Greschner. His shot blocked beautifully by Trottier.
Fine move, Brian Trottier. You're right, Jiggs. In this game so far, he's done just about everything.
He'll hit, he'll score, he'll block shots. Set up plays. Hedberg dumped the puck in. Vickers put it out in front of the net. Hedberg on the far boards to Greschner. Greschner being watched by Trottier. He gave it back to Hedberg. Vickers open in front of the net. They couldn't get it to him. Here's Greschner. Back to Hedberg. Hedberg to Greschner. Greschner's shot again. It goes off Trottier. Bob Bourne slaps it out of there.
Coaches will tell you when you're playing against Steve Vickers, particularly on a power play, he's always by the corner of the net. That is the left corner as you face the net. He's very dangerous in that position.
He's made a career out of camping there. Now the Rangers move in offside on this power play. We're down to 4 minutes and 4 seconds remaining in period number one. Fourth power play opportunity. Second for each team.
Diggs, there's a fella that's having himself a fine playoff season. Butch Goring has really been hustling through every series. Toronto, Edmonton, and with the New York Rangers. He has been doing it all. Penalty killing, faceoffs, regular shift. We saw him on the power play once at the point.
The whirling dervish. Danny Potvin killing off this penalty has dumped the puck down into the Ranger zone. First man in, Butch Goring, of course. Laidlaw around the boards. Katsopoulos takes a look. To Laidlaw. Back to Katsopoulos at center ice. Tries a long shot way wide of the goal. Comes off the boards. Rangers hold it in. Dahlin plays it to the open wing, and Potvin is there. Danny Potvin dumps it the length of the ice. Laidlaw back. Carroll right on top of him, forcing Laidlaw, the puck in the skates of Laidlaw, kick loose, and there's Goring again to the blue line for Potvin. He's shooting! That just went wide. Comes out on this near side. John Maloney dropped it back to Laidlaw, again to Maloney. Maloney to Allison, missed the pass, the puck loose, and the Rangers are offside.
Puck was rolling and bouncing. That slows the puck up. That's how the offside came. Allison, a little bit too quick, ruining an opportunity for the Rangers. Dennis Potvin, they love him here, don't they? They boo him every time he breathes. But he has been effective, leading with 5 power play goals in the playoffs. Now 14 seconds left of that hooking penalty against John Tonelli. Trottier got the draw, came back to center, and this is Beck. Across the line, but broken up and cleared by Lorimer. This time, clears at the length of the ice. So that all but does it. Tonelli on his skates. And he steps out on the ice. The teams are at 6 aside. Rangers into center. Duguay. Islanders up 1-0. Duguay's shot knocked down and cleared out of there by Lorimer. Again, the Rangers with no shots on that power play. Back to Hospodar. Had to turn to get away from Carroll. Gave it to Beck. Ahead to Vickers. Relayed it's intended for Duguay, and it was broken up by Carroll. Coming back is Barry Beck. 1-0 Islanders as Beck moves into center ice. Shot one around the board. Smith didn't get out of there in time. Here's Talifas with it. Lane takes him out of the play. And Lorimer slaps it out on the right wing into the center ice zone. Barry Beck. And again, Billy Carroll broke up the pass from Hospodar. Got the puck to Gillies. Gillies to Kallur. Knocked away from him by Vickers. And here's Duguay. Duguay dumping one in. Vickers chases it. Langevin lines him up. Takes him out of the play. And Lorimer gets a bump as well. But Carroll has it in his skates. Comes loose. Picked up by Duguay. Duguay out in front. Shoots. Blocked by Billy Carroll. Now Kallur is upended. And there will be a Ranger penalty.
Ron Duduay is going to get it again. Jiggs McDonald. He trips. Billy, or it's Andy Kallur. He trips up as Kallur breaks up the play. Duguay. His second tripping penalty of this period and the hockey game. We'll see it here as Kallur breaks up his attempt to pass it to the point. Duguay reaches out with a stick, pulls the feet out from underneath Billy Carroll. A flagrant tripping penalty. I'm surprised that someone like Ron Duguay, who has been the leader for the New York Rangers in the playoffs, has 2 tripping penalties, both of them very obvious penalties. He made no effort to try and conceal the fact that he was pulling feet out from underneath players, and he gets caught again. The Islanders had just scored on a power play opportunity. The Rangers just had one, did not get a shot. Now the Islanders, they're trading power plays here, and this is the thing the Rangers should stay away from.
Mike McEwen just fed the puck to Bossy, now to Trottier, back to Bossy. Bossy fired it in off the boards. Baker pokes it back of the net, picked up by Trottier. To the blue line, McEwen a drive. Bossy to shot Bourne, rather, and the rebound, and the Islanders lead 2-0.
Bourne. Bobby Bourne takes the rebound. The Islanders doing what they do so well, handling the puck. And Bob Bourne, this is Trottier, as you see him pass to McEwen. McEwen winding up to let the shot go. He lets it go, and a save by Steve Baker. But look there, right there. That's Bourne standing unprotected right in front of him as the shot, good shot by Mike McEwen, stopped by Baker, rebound is Bourne's, and Bobby Bourne, his third goal of the playoffs, gives the New York Islanders a 2-0 lead late in the first period.
Third playoff goal for Bob Bourne, his first in this series naturally, and now Wayne Merrick has dumped the puck into the Rangers zone. Katsopoulos failed to clear it out of there. Nystrom into the corner for Tonelli. Back to Nystrom. To Tonelli again. John Tonelli dumps it around the boards. Katsopoulos and Nystrom there together. Nystrom tied up. Pinned on the boards. And Nielsen dumps it right out in front of his own goal. But Greschner was there to feed it to Anders Hedberg. Hedberg's play broken up. Here's Beck with it again. Beck over to Vadney. Vadney to Hedberg. Nielsen sends Greschner over the line. Morrow broke that up partially. It's loose. Smith came diving out of the net, but the puck ended up in the far corner and is cleared by Morrow. That's going to go the length of the ice. Beck will go back to touch up. The Islanders called for icing. Well, I have just a moment here in the period. Mike Bossy with that opening goal tonight. Mike has been designated a special person. He is the head coach of the Nassau County Special Olympics for very special people. And Islander fans are invited to participate tomorrow between 10 a.m. and 1:30 at Adelphi Athletic Field on South Avenue in Garden City. It's their annual Special Olympics relays and track and field meet tomorrow.
I'm glad I know that, Jiggs. That is a great event. I know from experience. I helped coach a Special Olympics hockey team years ago. It's a lot of fun.
It sure is. And Mike Bossy,
the honorary head coach of the Special Olympics, and tomorrow's their day at Adelphi Athletic Field, 10 a.m. to 1:30. The Islanders have dumped the puck into the Rangers zone again and are going to be called for icing. We're down to 17 seconds remaining in this first period. Bossy at 14:36, then Bourne at 18:33, and Brian Trottier drawing an assist on the goal by Bob Bourne has now gone 19 consecutive playoff games with a point in each, at least a point in each. And if memory serves me correctly, that establishes a new National Hockey League record.
19 straight hockey games. That's not just playoffs, that's regular season?
No, that's playoffs.
That's just playoffs.
Just playoffs.
So I think the NHL record for consecutive points in regular season is a little higher than that.
Yeah.
25, 24. Something.
Quick shot from the faceoff was blocked. Fatio's rebound blocked in front of the Islander goal. Comes back to Beck. Beck fired through a screen, and Smith got in front of that. There's Goring to clear it. Harry Beck knocked it down at center. Picked up by Fatio. Nick Fatio drops it back as the buzzer sounds to end an entertaining opening period of hockey here at Madison Square Garden. The score at the end of the first period of play, the New York Islanders 2, the New York Rangers no score.
This bud's for everybody who puts in a hard day.
Defense. Referee Hood is waiting for Baker to get his catching glove in place. Now we're set to go. On the draw, Merrick got it to Nystrom, to Morrow, now to Potvin. Danny Potvin around the check of Allison, around another check. That was Vadane. He's over the line. Wound up for the shot, but the whistle it sounded.
Bob Nystrom anticipating Dennis Potvin to shoot the puck in. Potvin did not shoot it in. Nystrom across the blue line ahead of him. Offside, a little cross up of the signal. Get a good look at Dennis Potvin. What a nice move he made on Allison. Allison came in quickly, straight on. Potvin standing inside his own blue line, beat him easily.
Now Allison dumps the puck into the Islander zone. Nystrom up into Fatio. Play goes on. The Garden fans quick to rise on that. This is Beck chasing the puck back into his own zone. The right side for Don Maloney. Out into center ice off Vadney's stick. Fatio couldn't pick it up. Now Nick turning at the blue line. Back into his own zone. Fatio being hounded by Tonelli was able to clear the puck up the left wing side. Don Maloney over the line. Maloney in the corner. Looks for some help in front. Centered one, but right to Merrick. Now to Tonelli. At the right side for Nystrom. Bobby Nystrom dumping it into the Rangers' zone. Chasing it is Laidlaw. Tom Laidlaw at the blue line. Islanders have Bossy, Bourne, and Trottier out there. In quickly is Duguay. Centered it out in front, cleared aside by Lane. Trottier off the boards. Ryan Trottier calling, able to poke it loose at the blue line. Dean Talifas can't get set. And here's Bossy with Trottier. Trottier one-on-one with Katsopoulos. Cross the line. Bossy tied up Talifas. Trottier put it out in front. Bossy had been knocked down. Still managed to get a stick on it, but it went right to Baker. He was down on the ice and able to cover up.
Heavy checking. Both teams. This time it's the New York Rangers. Trottier and Bossy trying to create a two-on-one situation. It was not to happen. The Rangers get back quickly, particularly with the two players I just mentioned trying to get loose. The most dangerous twosome, I would have to think, in the National Hockey League on a two-on-one situation. Good covering by Laidlaw.
If there were wagering, they'd be odds on favored.
Yeah, no question.
Trottier against Duguay. Trottier won the draw, back to McEwen. McEwen shot, knocked down, and just went wide. Bossy got a piece of it. Rangers trying to clear it out. Talifas on the right wing. Bourne stepped in front of him. Bossy dug it loose, in along the boards, ran into referee Hood, and that gave Talifas a chance to pick it up. Talifas uses the boards to feed it to Duguay. Duguay shoots one in wide of Billy Smith, comes off the boards, picked up by Bourne. Bob Bourne dumps it to the blue line, knocked down, Katsopoulos a drive, that went wide of the net. Smith dives out on the rebound, and we'll get a face-off in the Islanders' zone. There's a break in the action with the score. New York Islanders 2, New York Rangers no score.
Al
Arbour, his 102nd playoff victory the other night in the 7-3 Islander win on Long Island. He is an elite group of six other coaches to have 100 or better Stanley Cup playoff wins.
Let's see, who would they be? Joe Blake comes to mind immediately.
Absolutely. Scotty Bowman, Dick Irvin.
Yeah.
Billy Ray, Fred Shiro, and Jack Adams.
Fred Shiro, Billy Ray.
Mm-hmm.
Former Chicago coach.
Sure.
The puck in the Rangers zone, but came in offside. Gillies being tied up at the time.
I'll give you to them and give you them in sequence, Jakes. The leader in that group is Dick Irvin. We look at Clark Gillies, big factor in this series, using his size and his speed and his shot so far. Dick Irvin has 190 wins. Scotty Bowman, 163. Toe Blake, 119. Billy Ray, 117. Fred Shiro, 108. And Jolly Jack Adams, the late Jack Adams, 105. He was Jolly Jack. What a hockey man with Detroit. Signed Gordie Howe.
Always one of the best interviews around. Puck has been cleared the length of the ice. Morrow around to the right side, off the stick of Sutter. Here's Beck with it at Sutter. Handed it right to Sutter, to Gillies. Mark Gillies to Goring, turns to pick it up. Butch Goring back at the line. Into the corner for Dwayne Sutter. Sutter to the blue line to Potvin. Potvin over to Goring. Butch Goring back to the point for Potvin. Dennis winds up, weak shot. And Sutter almost set up Goring on the pass, but it was broken up, and up to center ice come the Rangers. Hedberg across the line. Gave it to Greschner, chased to the corner. That's the center went out in front. Deflected high, Greschner holds it in. Hospodar shot one wide. Nielsen in the corner to Hedberg, back of the goal. Tried to put it out in front, Smith steers that aside. Hedberg again. Anders Hedberg, there's one wide of the goal and right to Morrow. To Sutter, Beck came in to tie him up. The Rangers still in control of it, broken up by Goring. Now Potvin can't get out of there, and the puck is deflected up into the crowd.
Anders Hedberg, what a play he made when Dennis Potvin misfired. Clark Gillies missed the puck and was going to Butch Goring on the open side. Hedberg moved in quickly to help his defense, and they brought the puck up the ice and had a couple of opportunities from the good check of Anders Hedberg on Butch Goring.
Now Billy Carroll has come out to center a line of Kallur and Bourne with Lane and Lorimer on the points. Adnay held it in. His shot went wide of Billy's fifth. Courtney Lane around to the right side. Kallur pokes it into center, and Vatnay gives chase. That's Billy Carroll forechecking for the Islanders. Vatnay to Valine at center, across the line. Valine on the far boards. Added it right to Bob Lorimer. To Carroll, couldn't get a stick on it. Here's Jerry Gillis. He couldn't put it out in front. Valine now. Tried to thread the needle. Lorimer took the mat out of the play. And Lane fed the puck around to the left side for Bob Bourne. Back to Lane. Chased by Valine. Lane to Kallur. He was thumped on a check by Laidlaw. Now Lorimer steps into Laidlaw as they go back of the net. In comes Billy Carroll as well. And the puck frozen on the boards for a faceoff. There's a break in the action with the score. The New York Islanders 2, the New York Rangers no score.
If I were a rich man, all day long I'd beady-beady-bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard.
This message is from Chemical Bank, whose savings programs can make you a little richer.
If I were a wealthy man!
The chemistry's just right for savers at Chemical.
There has been an obvious din in the building since the Rangers skated out onto the ice to open the hockey game.
On this play, Don Maloney slapping at it. The puck got underneath one of his teammates and dug loose. This is McEwen, 3-on-2 at center. Sends Nystrom in on the right wing. His shot got by Baker, but wide of the net. Trottier bumped by Nick Petillo and knocked out as Maloney feeds it rink wide. At center ice, Allison around Merrick across the line. Drop pass, Maloney couldn't control it. Here's Beck coming in from the point. Upended by Merrick, and there'll be a penalty. Wayne Merrick. Pulled back down, so the Islanders face a penalty-killing situation.
could almost be considered a good penalty on the side of the Islanders. I'll explain why when we come back from this break in the action with the score. The Islanders 2, the Rangers no score.
These people have something many other airline employees don't, a job. Because last year, while other airlines laid off almost 18,000 people, Eastern actually added some. We're trying to keep people because that means keeping service. And we don't think you should have to give up service just because times are tough. After all, I may get you to try Eastern once, but these are the people who make you want to come back. At Eastern, we have to earn our wings every day.
Has shot down the ice off the faceoff. The reason that could be considered a good penalty, Jiggs, is that Merrick hooked Beck, who had an open path all the way into Billy Smith. He could have broke in all alone on Smith.
Good penalty, Merrick for hooking, 4:44. Reschner fed it in, and it's cleared out of there by Morrow.
Something the Rangers have been doing a lot of in their power play is giving the puck up right at the Islander blue line. They don't seem to be sure of what they're going to do with the puck, and when they're not, they dump it in, and the Islanders get control.
Ulf Nielsen. Then Laidlaw across the Islander line. Nielsen in after the loose puck. Carroll knocked it away from him. It's Carroll and Goring up front with Potvin and Morrow. It's been cleared to the line. Greschner thought he had held it in, but the whistle sounds. Linesman Ron Finn, straddling the blue line, made the call.
Game of inches. The linesman in that case is always in an excellent position to see whether the puck actually gets out across the blue line. The only time he would not be able to see is if a winger or a defenseman were to get in front of him. As he stands right on the blue line, he can look all the way across it and gets usually an excellent look at whether the puck is over the blue line or not.
Islander penalty killers now are Bourne and Kallur. Morrow fell back of the net, the puck loose, Nielsen centered, out of the reach of Laidlaw, who was in deep. Anders Kallur turns, played it off Beck. Now Bob Bourne picks it up. Beck had been dragged to the ice by Morrow, and the fans thought there should have been a second Islander penalty.
The reason there wasn't, Jiggs, is because Barry Beck had a hold of the stick of Ken Morrow. That's the reason he fell.
Here's Hedberg over the line, shoveled it off to Beck, and his drive blocked by Morrow. Kenny Morrow covers up and clears at the length of the ice.
Excellent.
Has he played well?
Excellent. He's had an excellent playoff, had a pretty good last half of the season, but he's been outstanding again in this game. What a move he made on Barry Beck.
Now here's Gordy Lane back in his own zone. Turns and fires the puck into center ice for Goring. Goring to Billy Carroll. Carroll over the Ranger line. Shooting Baker the save. Carroll bumped on the boards as he tried to go back of the net. Then was knocked down. The puck went to Vickers. Around to Dean Talifas. 13 seconds left in the penalty against Merrick as Duguay gets to the Islander line. Vickers was halfway to the tunnel.
Bad play by Steve Vickers as he's way offside. He anticipates a pass from Ron Duguay. Duguay does not give it to him. Wingers, if they can, should hold up. The idea, of course, for a power play is to have five men in motion going into the other team's end of the ice. And Vickers wants the puck. He wants to keep that five-man attack moving, but the pass did not come. Vickers was a good 10 feet inside the Islanders' end.
Have they tested Billy Smith yet on this
no,
power play?
No, they have not.
Teams at six aside again as Merrick is back on. Duguay dumps the puck in wide of the Islander goal. Backboard is Lorimer. Around to the right side. Tonelli cleared it, but not out. Vadney's shot. Knocked down. Comes to center ice. Picked up by Nystrom. Across the Ranger line on his off wing. Nystrom around the check of Katsopoulos. Got it back in the net. Put it out in front. It hit one of the Rangers and bounces into center ice. Denny Potvin being booed as he comes back into his own zone. Potvin just played it out of the reach of Tonelli. Katsopoulos sent Allison over the line. Talifas, rather, with a shot that goes up into the crowd. There's a break in the action with the score. The New York Islanders 2, the New York Rangers no score.
This bud's for everyone who wraps it, stacks it, and sacks it.
This bud's for you. For all you do, the king of beers is coming through.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do.
This bud's for you.
Makes a save then. Bob Lorimer right then made a save on a shot
puck deflected into the seats. You notice that one of the fans is being taken out with the cut. Oh, it's a lady too. I hate to see anybody get cut, particularly a lady, and even worse would be a youngster, but hopefully they'll not be hurt too bad.
Now here's Hospodar from the blue line, and his shot goes up into the crowd again off a stick. The Rangers have not had a shot on goal through the first 7 minutes and 20 seconds of this second period.
Right now,
imagine Fatio right in the middle of things in front of the Islander goal.
Well, he's in there trying to block Billy Smith's view of the puck or deflect the puck in front. He is big, he's strong, and he seems to cover a lot of ice. Here's the shot by number 23, Ed Hospodar. There's Nick Fatio right in front of the net, along with McEwen. Takes a little shove at Billy Smith. Wants to keep things stirred up in front of the net if he can.
Billy keeping his cool. Langevin now has fired the puck into the Rangers zone. Number 22 is Fatio. Lost it on the boards. Merrick to Nystrom. Nystrom in the corner, giving a bump. Merrick with the puck in front to Tonelli. Around one check to the blue line to Langevin. This is McEwen with a drive. Baker the save, and he holds on. He felt the full force of that. We get another pileup. This time at the side of the Ranger goal as Dick's come up high. The Teal's right in the middle of that as well. I hate to center him out, but
well,
he's in
there.
And
that's
the action.
Jakes, and I'm going to tell you how silly it all started from. As we see the concern of Craig Patrick, he knows he does not want his team to have any more foolish penalties. The Islanders already have two power play goals, and that gives them the 2-0 lead. Petillo, a left hook at Langevin. Tempers are flaring, and there's now going to be penalties. Earlier, there was not going to be any, and we'll see what referee Bruce Hood is going to assess.
Go ahead, Jakes.
You can do it. A break in the action with the score of the New York Islanders 2 and the New York Rangers nothing.
WHN gives you Willie Nelson.
Whiskey River, take my mind. Don't let a memory talk to me. Whiskey River, don't run dry. I'm tired, all I got to hear me.
WHN, 1050 on your AM radio dial.
Thank you very much, Willie.
From the onset of this series, it was evident that the New York Rangers could not afford to take bad penalties against the best power play in the NHL, not only in the regular season, but also in the playoffs. Nick Fatio has just drawn a bad penalty, a roughing penalty, for throwing a left hook at Dave Langevin after everything had quieted down.
Well, here's Potvin centering the puck, Bourne a drive, and it just went wide of the net. Back to Dennis at the blue line. The Bossy. Bossy, rink wide, McEwen comes in off the point, centered one to Bossy, back to Potvin. Shooting, blocked in front as it hit Vatney. Mike McEwen around Duguay, tried to center one in front of the net, it got away from everybody, chasing it is Trottier. Ryan Trottier into the corner for Bourne, around Beck, Bourne lost control of it, it's picked up by Trottier to Potvin. Dennis from the blue line, his shot hits Halifax. Potvin again. Spinning into the corner for Bourne. Bourne comes off the boards, gave it to Potvin. His shot just went wide of the net. McEwen with the rebound. McEwen to Trottier, back on top of him. Bourne comes in to pick up the puck. Back to the blue line. Here's McEwen. He shoots. Baker the save. The rebound is loose. Cleared by Trottier. McEwen another shot. Baker the glove save, and he holds on.
What pressure by the New York Islanders. Barry Beck, what a job he's doing working on this penalty. Holding his position and covering a lot of players and a lot of ice. As the New York Islanders come very close, Beck, he took Trottier out. That's Bourne retrieving the puck back to McEwen. McEwen must have three shots on this power play. That one was fairly open. You could see that there was nobody in front. Baker could not hang on to the puck, though. Trottier, with Beck down, trying to check him, gets it back to McEwen again. And this time, his shot grabbed by Steve Baker and held on. That's the stoppage of play. Good pressure by the Islanders. Good positional work by the New York Rangers.
Gillies is out on this power play now. Gave it to McEwen. Back to Gillies. Into the corner to Bossy. In front to Potvin. It came off Baker's stick. Cleared by Don Maloney, and the Islanders have to go back.
Thing about penalty killing
Jiggs, you gamble a little bit. You have to at times when you're a man short. You gamble that either let the point man have his shot or their shots from the point and cover Bossy and Trottier in front, or you let Potvin and McEwen shoot it, and you have troubles.
Goring couldn't get around the defense. The Rangers able to clear it into center. That's Mike McEwen with it. McEwen being hounded at the time, lost control of it. And this is Maloney across the line, dragged down by Goring. Rangers with an opportunity, and it was slid wide by Gillies. Mark Gillies now tying it up on the boards, and the whistle sounds. 11 seconds left in the penalty to Patil, and Butch Goring is headed for the penalty box.
Let me just finish what I was trying to tell you, Jiggs, about the penalty killers. If they stay in close to the net to help the defensemen hang on to players like Bossy and Trottier, of course, they leave the point men to shoot the puck, as the Rangers have in this case. Here's the penalty. Butch Goring just got on Don Maloney, reaches out, hooks him from behind, gets him on the arms. Maloney was out on the edges of his skates, goes down, and Butch Goring gets a hooking penalty. As you mentioned, 11 seconds still remaining on Nick Petillo's roughing penalty. We see Nick Petillo up close, and he sees us. Face-off will be in the Islanders' end. They'll be at even strength for 11 seconds.
Islanders 2, the Rangers nothing. It's Lane and Lorimer, the Islander defense. Trottier and Bourne up front. Wolf Nielsen with Anders Hedberg for the Rangers. They have Beck and Greschner. Greschner has been playing as a forward, drop back on defense at the moment. They'll have the man advantage in 11 seconds, remember. And Trottier argues with Ron Finn after being waved out of the faceoff period. Bruce Hood comes over and tells him to hustle it up. It'll be Bourne on the draw now. Bourne got the draw to Lorimer. Check back of his own goal. Here's Hedberg with it. Hedberg at the side of the Islander net. Put it out in front. A drive. That just went wide as Nielsen unleashed one. Now Hedberg again trying to set up the play. To the point to Greschner. Rangers with a man advantage. Petillo is on the power play. A drive. Smith the glove save. Nielsen went for the top left-hand corner. And Billy Smith robbed him.
Good move Billy Smith makes on a save from Ulf Nielsen. That's Hedberg to Nielsen. One move, and he lets go a shot. Billy Smith, top left corner. He's got his catching glove. Three is back of the Rangers in the light uniform. Standing right to the right of Billy Smith was 22 of the Rangers, Nick Petihu, who had just returned from the penalty box. The Islanders are now a man short. The faceoff is in their end of the ice.
On the draw, the puck went to Hedberg. Turn, shoots. It hits somebody in front. Lorimer, I believe, and ends up in that pileup as Lorimer had been knocked down by Carroll that day. And Barry Beck and Lane doing a little shoving.
That all started. Ulf Nielsen cracked Gordy Lane across the top of the foot. And from there, Beck came in to help Nielsen and a little shoving. Players are going to do that in this particular kind of game, as they did on the island. Nothing broke into anything. Only one fight, really, in the two games, which is good. They've been keeping the sticks down and the elbows most of the time.
Benny Potvin coming out to question referee Bruce Hood on something. He's been sent out there by Coach Al Arbour, who is standing with the player's bench door partway open. And now Hood is coming back.
Something to do with the clock, possibly.
A minute 36 left in the penalty against Goring, it says. Goring went off at 9:37. We have played 10 minutes and 1 second. Greschner has come over to listen in along with Beck. This is an interesting case. Beck and Greschner are inside the referee's crease, and Potvin's standing on the edge of it where he's supposed to be. Now he skates in as well.
Well, there's five fingers up, signaling possibly 5 seconds, and somebody may be questioning as to whether or not the clock was running on the penalty side and not on the... I think they're synchronized somehow, or they're supposed to be. Mm-hmm. As the main timepiece clicks down, the penalties seconds tick off at the same time.
Well, if the clock has been running, it's down now to 9:58. 10:01, so I guess that's where the mix-up is. clock had been stopped at 10:01, and they've just wound it down to 9:58 left in the second period, and the penalty clock remains the same. A minute 36 left in Goring's call. 2-0 Islanders face off to the left of Billy Smith. Trottier got the drop from Nielsen to Lane, around to the right side to Bourne. That came in from the blue line. The puck comes loose. Hedberg with it. And there's Hedberg back to the blue line. Barry Beck winds up, shoots that one wide. It's off the boards. Greschner trying to hold it in. It was broken up and cleared by Bourne into center ice. Back for the Rangers. Badet and Lorimer doing a little shoving on the far side of the ice. Beck failed to pick up the puck. Lorimer got a hard hit from Beck as he dumped it into the Rangers' zone.
Rangers not having a successful power play. They've had Vadney up front trying to see if he can't get something going in the Islanders' end of the ice.
Now Ron Greschner gives it to Laidlaw on the right side. Tom Laidlaw to Vadney. He couldn't get into the Islanders' zone on the first attempt. Now plays one to Hedberg. It's across the line, poked it around Morrow. Can't pick it up as Morrow gave him a good check. Now Hedberg back on his skates. Back of the goal to Nielsen. Off Nielsen, chased by Denny Potvin. Nielsen going to the ice. Potvin on top of him. Hedberg picks up the puck. Anders Hedberg into the corner. Hedberg still looks for a man to the blue line. A quick shot went wide. Hit the mesh at the back of the goal. Potvin knocked out of the puck beneath him.
Vadney hit Billy Smith across the face with the stick. You saw Smith sprawl on the ice trying to draw the attention of the referee. That's Katsopoulos, number 24, after Dennis Potvin.
Potvin was having words originally with Hedberg, just talking, and then all of a sudden in came Katsopoulos. And as you pointed out, in front of the net, Vadney and Smith. And they're not finished. Billy Smith just gestured with the stick in the direction of Vadney as he came to the side of the goal. Morrow has come out to act as policeman there. And I don't think referee Bruce Hood, has he called a penalty? Yes.
Not yet. Now he just signaled he was going to do something. And
he's got somebody going.
He's waving. He's looking at Vadney, apparently, and pointing to the box.
Laidlaw.
Laidlaw. He's got waltzing over with him. There's a break in the action with the score. The Islanders 2, the Rangers no score.
New York Yankees baseball coming your way on Sports Channel this Monday night when the Yanks take on the Angels in California. Catch all the action live starting at 10:30 right here on Sports Channel. Sports Channel, your box seat to New York sports at home.
Laidlaw, you get another close-up view. A handheld camera is off for roughing. That seems to be the only penalty assessed. Goring is still in the box. He has 16 seconds remaining in his penalty. Laidlaw gets a roughing penalty for his actions in that skirmish. Looking at Carroll Vadney, he took his stick. Of course, Billy Smith wears a birdcage kind of mask. It did not hurt Billy Smith, but Vadney took a backhand swipe. As his face to play, he reached back with his stick and wrapped it across the face mask of Billy Smith. Smith, knowing the puck was not in an extremely dangerous position, fell down on the ice, sprawled out like he'd been chopped in half, trying to draw attention to the play, trying to get Bruce Hood's attention on the play, but did not do so.
You're not going to fool Bruce very often.
No. Just wondering why they would have somebody like Carroll Vadney up front for the first time that I have ever seen on the power play. Usually they've used Beck up there.
Here's a chance for Bossy as he picks up the puck at center ice. DeBoro now across the line with Trottier moving in. Trottier all alone. Can't get by Bakers. He was knocked out, and there'll be a penalty here. Referee Bruce Hood is signaling a penalty, and the Rangers will be two men short.
It's a hooking penalty as Trottier goes in all alone. The Rangers draw a two-minute penalty, number 14, I believe. Mike Allison
As Ken Morrow makes a perfect pass, there goes Trottier. Look at the hack there. That's by Allison. He gets a hold of Brian Trottier's arm, and then Trottier slides in to goaltender Steve Baker. Takes a little chop from one of the Rangers as he was laying down. But the Rangers now, Mike Allison gets a hooking penalty. Laidlaw, number two, is in the box. He still has a minute and 39 seconds remaining. So the Islanders have a two-man advantage. Faceoff is in the Rangers' end of the ice. Good opportunity for the Islanders to open up a 3-0 lead. A minute and 39 before the first player, Laidlaw, gets out of the box.
Duguay, Beck, and Vadney for the Rangers. Trottier, Bossy, and Gillies up front. At the points, McEwen and Potvin. Potvin held it in at the line. Over to McEwen. McEwen centers. Here's Bossy. Shoots. Baker just got a piece of it and went up into the crowd, forcing another faceoff.
Good save by Steve Baker. Bossy standing in one of his favorite places, just off the net, about 20 feet out. He takes the puck and shoots it immediately. Scored a goal the other night in that same position.
Two-man advantage, a minute and 39 seconds long, as we saw a young Islander fan.
You know who that
garden?
Young Islander fan looked like? Looked like Artie Torrey.
Hey, Ben, I didn't get a good look at him.
Bill Torrey, the general manager. He's president general manager. Did look a little like Artie Torrey, who is an avid, of course, Islander fan.
I'll let you identify that party.
I do not know who that is, Jake.
Okay. On the draw, the puck went right in front of the Ranger goal. Gillies have been knocked down by Beck. Here's Trottier with it now. Ryan Trottier, rink wide. Potvin comes in on the left side to the blue line. Bossy a drive. Baker the pad save. Duguay with the rebound gives it to Beck. Barry Beck forces the Islanders back. Billy Smith plays it up the left wing quickly for Bossy. Back to McEwen. Mike McEwen at center ice. Cross that Ranger line. Looks for some help. Gave it to Potvin. Dennis into the corner for Mike Bossy as he came off bad name. Bossy back to Potvin. Potvin, a drive. Blocked in front. Baker, the glove save.
What a save by Steve Baker, Jiggs, on that drive. Dennis Potvin had lots of time. He got a lot on it. The only problem with the shot was that it might have been a little too high if he'd have kept it a little lower. As we see Potvin, look at him. He moves in, steps into it. Duguay moving out of the way. That's surprising, too. But Steve Baker makes the save. Obviously, I guess Duguay felt that he'd let the goaltender get a better look at it, which sometimes is smart, depending on the angle and where he's shooting from. But Steve Baker, another good save. This one off Dennis Potvin. Earlier it was off Michael Bossy.
Katsopoulos has gone to the bench and is replaced again by Vadney. Duguay and Trottier had moved in, and linesman Kevin Collins is waving Duguay out. So Beck will take the draw as a concerned Craig Patrick looks on. Puck cleared behind the Ranger goal. Vadney to Duguay, tips it into center ice. Back comes Mike McEwen. McEwen up the left side to Potvin. Dennis, rink wide to Gillies, across the line. Trottier goes to the net. Mark Gillies to the blue line to McEwen. McEwen moves in, stops. That's the shot goal. Baker got in front of that. The rebound ends up back of the net. Bossy unable to pick it up. Vadney falls, has the puck beneath him. Islanders backed away from him, but all we get is a whistle.
23 seconds remaining in Laidlaw's penalty. 45 seconds remaining in Mike Allison's penalty. Islanders look a little anxious, Jiggs, to get the shots on the net rather than move the puck around and try and get one of the Ranger defenders to get out of position. They have been shooting the puck regularly from well out. They should be moving the puck around more, passing it in and out, moving players from the sides of the net in front of the goaltender. You'll notice that several of the shots that were taken, there was no one in front of goaltender Baker to screen him or to tip the puck.
According to the shots on goal board, the Islanders have had four shots with this two-man advantage. Haven't been able to beat Baker. Puck has been frozen on the boards in that Ranger zone. Tuesday night, game four of this series, and we'll have it for you here on Sports Channel, beginning at 8:30.
But the Islanders, you know, they should be working the puck around for the one good chance. Five against three, they should be moving the puck back and forth. And the forwards, as I say, two of them should be parked in around the net, and one should just roam, and you can move the puck around and get that one forward a little out of position and get the good shot.
Trottier from back of the net to Bourne. A shot blocked by Baker. Eddie Potvin to Bossy. Back to Potvin. McEwen open. Gave it to Mike McEwen. Back to Potvin. Dennis starts to move in. Duguay right on top of him. Potvin over to McEwen. Laidlaw is out of the box. McEwen shot. Pad save again. The puck cleared into center. Here's Laidlaw chasing its fifth way out of the net. Balls on it. And holds on.
The fans like to boo anything. Billy Smith actually made a good play as Laidlaw, who had come out of the penalty box, was boring down on him. But at the other end, Steve Baker, what a job he's been doing. This is McEwen with a shot. Saved by Baker. Look where the rebound goes, and there's no Islanders. Look where they are, all three forwards, straight across. They have to stagger themselves. But they haven't. They have not played the five-on-three well. The Rangers have done a good job in breaking it up. They should not have been able to touch the puck if the Islanders had played it right. Baker was the standout in the Rangers' defense of the five-on-three. There's still 13 seconds remaining in the penalty to Allison.
The crowd just gave the Rangers a standing ovation. They've killed off the two-man disadvantage. Hoping that that will get something going for this Ranger club. Allison back on now, so the team's at equal strength. 2-0 Islanders. Late in period number two, Bourne in forechecking along with Kallur and Goring for the Islanders. The KGB line is together again. The puck deflected off Lorimer at the Ranger line and into the Islander players' bench.
That's an inspirational move, the Rangers killing off a two-man advantage that the Islanders were having. There's some of the folks that are up at level five in the building where we are. Abbott Ranger fans are very boisterous. They have not had much to be boisterous about, Jake, but that killing off a two-man advantage has got to be inspirational, as I say, not only to the players, it's the fans also.
Now the Rangers, Katsopoulos, fed it into center ice. Lorimer fires it right back in again. This is Laidlaw being chased by Kallur. Tonelli, rather. Laidlaw back of the goal, out on the far side, ahead for Hedberg, off his stick. This is Greschner shooting the puck into the Islander territory. Billy Smith left it for Lane. Gordy, number 24, his chance to play after the injury to Persson, and Smith just came up with a glove save off Nielsen and held on. There's a break in the action with the score. The New York Islanders 2, the New York Rangers no score.
Neither a borrower nor a lender be.
Excuse me. At Shearson Loeb Rhodes, we don't accept that investment advice.
Shearson Loeb Rhodes?
One of America's most respected investment firms. We say take advantage of every opportunity in stocks, real estate, municipal bonds, whatever's right for you.
But who knows what is right for me?
The answer is Shearson.
When the question is money, the answer is Shearson.
The Rangers have fared well so far. 5:32 in this period. They've had only one shot. The Islanders have had 11, but they haven't been able to score. They've had several advantages. One a two-man one, and two shorthanded one-man advantage.
This is Gordy Lane feeding it to Merrick. Off his stick into center ice. Hospodar shot going high. Smith flagged it down. Played it to Lane. And two Rangers in quickly on top of him. It's Allison with the puck. Allison tried to put it out in front. Lane got back to clear the rebound. Natsopoulos taking Hospodar in around the boards. Don Maloney unable to center it. Merrick and Lorimer there. Fatio come in late. We'll get a whistle.
He can lean on you, Nick Fatio. He came in late, made the hit. The whistle hadn't blown, but his own man, number 12, Don Maloney, took the brunt of the force.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the New York Islanders and is intended solely for the private, non-commercial use of our audience. Any publication, reproduction, retransmission, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this game without the express written consent of the New York Islanders and Sports Channel is prohibited.
While you were giving the disclaimer, Jakes, the cameramen were showing all the rigging hanging from the rafters here at Madison Square Garden. The circus, of course, is in town. They had a performance this afternoon, earlier this evening. They have it all suspended. Looks like some kind of art form as it hangs there, all kinds of it. Bruce Hood has signaled Islander players back to the bench.
We're just looking at a man who regards a peanut butter and Spanish onion sandwich as a delicacy. That's Bruce's favorite food.
Is that right? I never thought I had something in common with him. that's a great sandwich.
Really?
Yes, it is. Spanish onion, yeah.
Ever try Miracle Whip on peanut butter?
No. How about just plain Velveeta cream cheese with the onion?
I get hungry just thinking about it.
We're going to get you a gourmet show on cablevision this summer, perhaps.
Langevin failed to clear it in his own zone. A drive from the point. That just tipped wide. As Laidlaw let the shot go, and out comes Nystrom. Bob Nystrom across the Ranger line, coming in on the left side, trying to go in around Talipas, put it out in front. Here's Morrow. A drive. He scores! Kenny Morrow with a third Islander goal of the game.
It was Bobby Nystrom getting the puck into the Rangers' end of the ice that set the goal up. Kenny Morrow, who had scored the only overtime goal for the Islanders this season against Edmonton. That's Talifas chasing Nystrom. He tries to dump it in front. No one there. It's off the boards. And watch Kenny Morrow. He has lots of time. He tees it up, gets good wood on it. Baker is screened. He does not see it. And it goes into the top left corner. That's on the short side. And the Islanders have taken a 3-0 lead here late in the second period. 4 minutes and 29 seconds remaining in the second period. As I had mentioned, the Rangers have had but one shot in the second period so far. The Islanders have had 12. The Islanders have finally scored. After having a two-man advantage one time, they were a power play one-man advantage twice.
Nystrom, the only assist on the goal. It comes at 15:31 of the second period. Now here's Hedberg over the Islander line. Chased to the corner by Morrow. Hedberg put it out in front. That deflected off his skate. It's loose on the near boards. And Bob Bourne cleared it to the line. Gatsopoulos trying to come in. Turned around by Trottier. And out comes Bourne. Bossy moving up with him. Bourne across the line. Takes a shot. Hit Baker and went wide. Now Ron Greschner for the Rangers. Fed it into center to Beck. Back across the Islander line. Morrow checked him. The puck loose for Greschner. Greschner's shot. Smith the save, and he holds on. Just held it out. Telling Mr. Hedberg, I've got it safely right here.
Rather sarcastically, but Billy Smith saying, I've got it, you have it. You're not going to get it. And all the things you're going to do to me, you can send Nick Petillo after me. You can send Carol Vadney after me. You can do whatever you want. But I want the puck. I've got it. See you later.
Billy Smith has developed a little disco dance of his own in that goal mouth when the play stops.
He has to be feeling good about his teammates in front of him. Himself, he has played well. He has not had to play spectacular. That was the Rangers' first shot here in the second period.
His league stats in the playoffs had inflated goals against average. They had him playing 20 minutes less than he had actually played. And when they get that added in, it brings his goals against down to 2.40. The best of any of the goaltenders in playoff action this year. Petillo had to chase the puck into center ice. Nick carrying it back into his own zone. Gave it to Mike Allison, the rookie, to Hospodar. Hospodar at center, shot it in off Langevin. It bounces in front of the goal. Smith out of the net to clear it. We're going to get an Islander penalty as Petillo had been knocked down. The puck loose in the Islander zone. Rangers boarding it after it as they get the extra man on, but now play is called. The side of the goal, Allison was falling. As he backed into Billy Smith.
He was falling down. Billy Smith was trying to catch him, actually. But Dave Langevin is drawing a penalty. Bruce Hood caught him taking Nick Petillo down, a holding penalty as the signal comes from referee Bruce Hood. Dave Langevin questions Hood as he goes by him on the way to the box. 3:16 remaining in the second period. Here's the penalty. That's 22. Petillo trying to get in for the loose puck. And that's Dave Langevin getting an elbow into his chest, knocking him down, getting the penalty for that particular action.
I'm going to call it interference at 16:44.
I thought he had reached out. Generally, when the referee reaches out, clasps his one wrist with his hand, it signals holding. But obviously, he had crossed his arms. That's interference.
Hedberg, a quick shot. Smith, the stick save, and here's Potvin. Round to Trottier. He was
bumped on the boards, a pile up and a face-off again in the circle to the left of the Islander goal.
Quick shot by Hedberg right off the face-off. Ulf Nielsen is very good at face-off jigs. He often will turn his hand over on the lower. There, he just did there. See how his hand is, he's telegraphing how he's going to take the face-off, but he is so good at it, it doesn't seem to matter. He wins more than he loses.
Offhand had just cleared the puck to center. This is Vadday back for the Rangers. Well, he didn't seem to know which way to go, neither did Nielsen, and the Rangers had to go all the way back of the net. Nielsen, checked by Billy Carroll. Ulf Nielsen picks it up again. Head now to Vadney. Vadney had a stick lifted off the puck by Carroll. Vadney to Beck, and Morrow rode hurt on him beautifully. Good penalty killing as the Islanders force the Rangers to go back.
The Rangers are hesitating, Jake. They're not sure just where they want to make the play. They're not sure of each other. We just saw Nielsen and
Carroll. Billy Carroll taken away from Hedberg again. Carroll in that far corner. Greschner comes in along with Hedberg. The puck knocked loose. Billy Carroll along with Goring. What a penalty killing duo they've become. This is Allison at center ice. Across the Islander line. Mike Allison around Morrow. Centered the puck right to Kenny Morrow, and he clears it to center. Here's a break for Bourne. Katsopoulos back as Bourne races into the Ranger zone. Shooting, and it hit the stick of Katsopoulos and went up into the crowd.
Good defensive move by Chris Katsopoulos on speedy Bob Bourne. Bourne had somewhat of a break, but Katsopoulos played him perfectly. Bourne, very deceptive because of his speed, and he can go either way. That means he can go left or right to beat a defenseman. Here's Bourne racing through center. That's across the Rangers' blue line. He tries to cut back on Katsopoulos, but Katsopoulos, good balance, moving back, waiting, and Bourne came to him. He deflected the puck into the seats.
Now 36 seconds remaining in the penalty against Langevin as Bourne picks up the puck. Bourne in that Ranger zone, couldn't get around Duguay, falling at center as he dropped it back for Morrow. Off the boards to Kallur. Kallur's clearing attempt went right to Duguay, right side. This is Talifas coming in, gave it to Duguay, and a shot cut off by Potvin. Now to Bourne, to Kallur. Anders Kallur into center ice, ragging the puck as he cuts to the right and dumps one into the corner. That will all but kill off the penalty to Langevin. The Rangers give the puck to Vickers. Back to Laidlaw. Langevin steps out of the penalty box. Teams at six aside. Minute 13 left in the second period. Billy Carroll in forechecking in the Rangers zone. Carroll to the blue line for Lorimer. A drive. Good save by Baker as he came up on top of that goal crease to make the stop. And Lorimer picks it up again at center. Bob Lorimer to Potvin on the left side. Back to Lorimer. Lorimer takes his time, gave it to Potvin. 3-0 Islander lead as Talifas goes back for the Rangers. Gave it to Fatio. Fatio racing it over the line, trying to come in on goal. He shoots. Smith got his arm on it. Here's Potvin on the left wing boards. Potvin into center ice to Carroll. Billy Carroll shoots one around the boards. 30 seconds left in the period. A loose puck. Merrick overskated it. Here's Tonelli for the Islanders. John Tonelli to Nystrom. His shot blocked by Baker and a dazzling save. Fatio takes it into center, out of the reach of Talifas. Lane is back. We have 16 seconds left in the period as Lane dumps the puck into the Rangers zone. Chasing it is Katsopoulos. Katsopoulos around the boards to Fatio. It bounced away from him. Merrick back to Nystrom. Nystrom shoots. He scores! Nystrom with 5 seconds left in the period, and it's 4-0 Islanders.
And what a blast. It was a mistake again by the New York Rangers that led to the Islanders getting a hold of the puck. And that man right there, number 23, Bobby Nystrom, pulls the trigger and puts it behind Steve Baker. Here's Katsopoulos. Now the Rangers have possession. He dumps the puck up high on the boards. It hit the glass. Comes right out to Wayne Merrick, who tips it back. There's Nystrom. And from about 18 to 20 feet, he puts it in the top left-hand corner. And the New York Islanders have taken a 4-0 lead here in the second period that has seen the New York Rangers have but 4 shots in the period.
And there's the buzzer ending period number 2. The Islanders, with a goal by Morrow and another by Kenny Nystrom, Bob Nystrom after Kenny Morrow's goal, head to the dressing room at the end of 2 periods. The score, the New York Islanders box forces a face-off midway between the center ice stripe and the Ranger blue line.
a long way back for the New York Rangers. They need 5 goals at this point to win the hockey game. They need 4 to tie it. We see Bob Nystrom seems to have a comfort and seems to play better right now on left wing. Easier anyway for him, it seems, than he does on right wing, Jiggs. He handles the puck. He makes some good moves and beat on the goal by Morrow. He made a fine move to get around Talifas and get the puck to Morrow.
Yeah, you're right. You see a lot of guys' left-handed shots move over and play the right wing. You don't see that many right-handed shots play the left side. Nystrom reports a right-handed shot. The puck in the Islanders' zone. It hit Merrick. Nystrom fed it back to Wayne Merrick into center ice, out of the reach of Tonelli, however. This is Duque. He's checked by Merrick. Dropped it to Lane, out of Morrow. Any Morrow waited off a Ranger into the New York Rangers' zone. Tonelli is upended on a hard hip check from Katsopoulos. And Tonelli on the limp a little, shaken up as he heads back to the player's bench. Here's Ron Duque. Sends Gillis across the line. Gillis a shot that rolls over top of the goal, comes off the left wing for Bourne. Bob Bourne across the line, speeding into that Ranger zone, trying to come back to the net, does, put it out in front, it's deflected and tipped away by Laidlaw. Laidlaw around the boards on the left side. This is Gillis with it. Gary Gillis ran into Lane, and the puck is cleared. Picked up by Bossy on the right wing. That's Lane on the far side, playing it rink wide to Bossy. Into center ice, ahead for Billy Carroll. Carroll had trouble getting around Don Maloney. Now he runs into Beck. The puck ends up at the Ranger line for Allison. Allison checked by Bourne. Couldn't pick it up again as Vadney cleared it. At center ice, Darlene for the Rangers across the line. A long shot. Smith steered that aside. Comes out on the right wing for Bossy. Rink wide to Clark Gillies. Carroll moving up with him, 2-on-2. Gillies over the line against Vadney, and he shot it into the crowd. There's a break in the action with the score. New York Islanders 4, the New York Rangers nothing.
Watch out, you're driving into an ambush. That's right, your beautiful new car's finish has some deadly enemies.
I need help.
You need Ultra Seal, the incredible new protective sealer that shields your finish invisibly for 3 full years.
Now that is shining.
And it stays like that with no waxing or polishing.
You mean?
Just water, and that Ultra Seal shine will last.
For 3 full years?
For 3 full years.
Hey, how do I get an Ultra Seal finish?
Just ask your new car dealer.
A hard check taken by John Tonelli. That's Kostopoulos, number 24, as he gets his hip into the oncoming John Tonelli. Tonelli went to the bench injured. We don't know how bad. He's on the bench, and we'll bring you up to date as soon as we know anything.
Goring, Gillies, and Dwayne Sutter for the Islanders. Sutter shooting it into the Rangers' zone. Gillies chasing it with Kostopoulos. They go back to the net, and Allison picks it up. They get Hedberg and Nielsen. The Greshner is the forward line. This is Hedberg racing into the Islanders' zone. Potvin stepped in front of him. Greshner back of the goal. Comes out in front, turn, shoot. Smith got a piece of that. Andy Potvin may have blocked it. It was Potvin that it hit. Comes back to Katsopoulos. Slapped it off the boards and also off Gillies. Katsopoulos waiting outside the line to Laidlaw. Now Nielsen sends Greshner across the line. Greshner a shot. Smith steers it aside. Wayne Sutter taken to the boards. In comes Morrow, and we'll get a face-off to the right of Billy Smith.
Close call. Dennis Potvin got down in front of the puck. Both defensemen for the Islanders at one time. Morrow and Potvin behind the net. One out of position. Never should you have both defensemen behind the net. Always one in front of the net. Close call, but Potvin scrambled back without his hockey stick, took a dive, and the puck deflected away. There's Eddie Johnstone, ejected young fella, out with a knee injury, will not play in the playoffs. Missed greatly by the New York Rangers hockey team. He has always been a very effective player against the Islanders, a real spark plug for the Rangers.
Represented the Rangers in the All-Star game this year. Nystrom at center ice, checked by Ron Duque. And Duque couldn't go anywhere. Beck over to Vadney. Up that right wing side. Talifas sends Duque over the line, but offside.
an unusual offside, Jiggs. He put himself offside in the sense that he had his skates across the line. The puck was not over yet, and he bounced the puck off the far boards. And by the time the puck got across the line, he was a good 2 or 3 feet beyond it. A lot of close checking at center ice again, kind of bogging down. The fans kind of settle down in their seats along with it.
And they've got Jerry Gillis playing the left side with Duguay and Talathus. Vickers had been on the left side of this line for most of the series, if not all, until this point. Just went into the crowd, by the way.
He has not been out. Vickers has not played that much. He didn't play at all, I don't think, in the second period. He's out a few times in the first. Walter Tkachuk, we should mention, is again behind the bench, along with general manager and coach Craig Patrick. Tkachuk wearing a headset in contact. Probably with John Davidson, who's sitting up here.
John has moved down between the two benches, and they've got Wayne Thomas up here with us now.
All right, did not notice that, thank you.
This is Talathus back for the Rangers to Vadney, off the boards into center, and Langevin waited for his teammates to get back before dumping one in that was just wide of the net. Around the left side, Gillis unable to bring it out. This is Mike McEwen into the corner to Nystrom, comes out in front, gave it to Merrick, he shoots, oh, and it just went wide. Baker came out to challenge him. Now Beck bumped solidly by Nystrom. Duguay feeds it off to Vadney at the Ranger line. Vadney at center. Merrick checked in. Here's John Tonelli back out there. Tonelli with Nystrom, then Wayne Merrick. Langevin back for the Islanders has shot it into his player's bench, and there's no further play. There's a break in the action with the score. The New York Islanders 4, the New York Rangers nothing.
Fire Company C, Manhattan. The last thing these guys have time to do is to wait online to cash their checks. So their Chemical Bank branch manager gave them a hand. He opened a special line so that when the firemen come in to cash their checks, they can get out fast. It's one of the ways we tailor each Chemical Bank branch to the needs of the community. As bankers, sure, we like to see them save money. As citizens, we want to see them save lives.
Rangers being subjected to some very close checking by the New York Islanders.
Gatsopoulos, a long shot following the draw. Billy Smith grabbed it at the side of the net and elected to force another faceoff.
Something the Islanders would not want to do is play the period in their own end of the ice. The check by Gatsopoulos on John Tonelli seemed to rally the Rangers just for a shift or two. And now they've settled back a little bit, but they are in the Islanders' end of the ice.
On this draw, Allison was turned around, got the puck to Gatsopoulos, his shot hit Billy Carroll and picked up by Kallur. Kallur sandwiched between Allison and Maloney. Now Carroll sends Kallur up the right side over that Ranger line, trying to come in around Gatsopoulos. Kallur knocked down on the boards. Laidlaw headed back of the goal, and Valleen starts out on the right side. Across the line. The pass picked up by Allison as he went to the corner, worked it around to the open wing. Laidlaw comes in. Tom Laidlaw, all the way in from the blue line, tried to sneak back of the goal. Now Allison and Lane bump together. The puck loose. Gillies unable to get a stick on it. It's back of the Islander goal for Lorimer. Bob Lorimer to Kallur, cleared it but not out. Laidlaw's shot was knocked down. Baleen shoots. He scores.
Give them enough opportunities and they'll get a goal, and that's what happened. The Islanders, in their own end of the ice, failed to clear it, and Valleen scores the goal. Valleen, his second goal right here as he goes across in front of the net. Gordy Lane, 24, trying to get to him. That's Allison, number 14, right in front of Billy Smith, looking for a rebound. Here's another angle of that shot, a good clean shot that beat Billy Smith. He shot the puck back to where Billy Smith was standing when he started out across in front of him. And the New York Rangers have now given their fans something to cheer about. It's 4-1, Valleen scoring his second goal of the playoffs.
The goal comes at 5:13. We'll see what effect that has on the New York Rangers now. But here's Bossy on right wing. Shooting Baker, the pad save. He was way up on top of the goal crease again on that attempt. Offhand forced back into the Islanders zone. Turns to try and get away from Ulf Nielsen. Nielsen right on top of him. Bourne there to help out, and Potvin has cleared it into center ice. Gary Beck. Edberg. Edberg dumps one in. Smith comes out to cut it off. Plays it back of the goal to Dennis Potvin. Potvin backhands it into the center ice territory. Vadney going back for the Rangers. Icing has been waved off. Both teams in the middle of player changes. Goring has come out along with Sutter and Clark Gillies. This is Hedberg into the Islanders zone. Poked it through the defense, but offside, they rule. There's a break in the action. We have 13:52 remaining in this third period. And the scores, the New York Islanders 4, the New York Rangers 1.
Why use a There Tomorrow package service when Sprint's Eastern Same Day service gets it there today? Eastern tags it and bags it and gets it on the next flight out. And that's over 1,400 of them to 85 cities every day. Your package is there today, guaranteed, or your money back. So when it has to get there today, you've got to hand it to Sprint. Eastern Same Day package service.
Play underway. The Rangers trying to put it out in front of that Islander goal, and it was broken up. Clark Gillies dumps the puck to center. Katsopoulos back. Shot it high in the air into the Islander zone. Off the boards. McEwen tied up immediately by Duguay. The puck came loose for Goring, who was back quickly. Goring ahead to Gillies on the left side. Drop pass for Goring. Goring shoots it into the Ranger zone, then heads for the player's bench. Out comes Wayne Merrick to take Goring's spot. Gillies up the left side. Harry Gillies fires it wide of the Islander goal off the boards. Duguay with it. He plays it around behind the net. Gillies forechecking. And the puck cleared to the left side. Here's Tonelli. Has a break at center. Merrick moving up with him. Merrick takes the pass. Comes in. Checked by Beck. Wayne Merrick to the blue line. Beck has been hurt. Laying a drive. That went wide of the net. And now play is called. Beck went into the boards heavily.
Went in backwards, Jiggs. And there's no way to control your body when you're on the ice. You're going fast. And he was going backwards as he slid into the boards. Wayne Merrick had a break. Beck came in behind, made a good move to check Wayne Merrick, but he fell in trying to get to Merrick, and he did get to him. He put a check on Merrick. Merrick did not get the shot away. As you see, he falls, and he slides backwards. He cannot control his body going backwards. And as he falls backwards into the boards, he hits his head. Watch his head snap here as he goes down, loses control, puts his arm up, but you can see the snap on his neck as he goes into the boards. He seems to be all right. He's a pretty tough guy, has played a lot of hockey for the New York Rangers tonight. He's been on the ice more than any other player from both teams and made a good play there getting back to Wayne Merrick, who was going in all alone.
Now the Rangers have dumped the puck to center, picked up there by Gordy Lane. We have 12:25 left in regulation time. The Islanders lead it 4-1 as Nystrom comes in quickly. Back to the New York Ranger goal. Nystrom zigzagging. The puck knocked off his stick. Comes to the corner for Don Maloney. Maloney played it off Tonelli into center ice, and Lane fires it right back into the Ranger zone. Nystrom took a run at Laidlaw. The Rangers come to center ice on left wing as Allison cuts to the right. Then was checked by Tonelli. Allison with it again. It was knocked away from him. Don Maloney in the far corner. Lane poked it off his stick. Wayne Merrick kicks it around the boards, intended for Tonelli. Picked up again, and Merrick just dumps it down into the Rangers zone. That's going to result in an icing call. And we'll get a face-off deep in the Islanders zone as a result. 11:38 left in regulation time as we look at Al Arbour.
Obviously wants to make sure his team does not play the period. In their end of the ice, the Rangers have scored here in the third period. Territorially, the Rangers have been dominating the play so far. If they get another goal, Jiggs, they could all of a sudden be a threat to the Islanders. It's 4-1 now, 11 minutes and 38 seconds remaining in the third period. They are down by 3. They were down by 4 at the beginning of the period. They have scored 1. And they're looking for another one, and they are getting a few opportunities.
Islanders have had 2 shots on goal this period. The Rangers have had 4. Beck is back out there. Played it around the boards in the Islanders zone. This is Billy Carroll. He, Trottier, and Bossy up front. Make it Kallur, rather, on the right side. And now Trottier has gone to the bench and is replaced by Clark Gillies. So Carroll moves to center. Kallur and Gillies on the wings. Beck starting out for the New York Rangers. Got it to Hedberger, dumps the puck into the Islanders zone. Nobody touched it. Potvin does now, and that's icing against the Rangers. We're down to 11:04 left in regulation time. Haven't had a penalty called here through the first 8 minutes, almost nine of the final period.
Players are content to try and skate and hit and make the plays. Sandy Kallur has come back after his groin pull, kept him out of the early going of the playoffs.
And a pretty shorthanded goal against this Ranger team at the Coliseum the other night. There's Carroll with a quick shot, and goaltender Steve Baker had to be sharp on that one. The alertness of Billy Carroll, a big plus for this Islander team. And now it's been shot down the ice into the Ranger zone, icing once more.
Billy Carroll, what a pleasant surprise for the Islanders management and the rest of the players, because he has been brought into the position originally he was brought in to replace an injury, and has shown himself very well, as has Hector Marini. Two different styles of hockey player. Carroll is a fluent skater. He looks like he could skate all day, has several ranges of speed, but when he's got it open, he can move.
Recall Al Arbour, I think in January, mentioning the fact that he had been to Indianapolis to watch a game, said then that Billy Carroll was ready to play in the league.
Not easy to break into a lineup such as the Islanders either.
That's for sure. A lot of guys will confirm that. Trottier clearing the puck into center ice. McEwen dumped it right back into the Rangers zone. Laidlaw with it. Headed to the Islander line. McEwen up the right side to Bossy, to Trottier over the line with Bourne. Ryan Trottier was checked on the play by Laidlaw. Down to the far corner. Rangers come to center, led by Duguay over the Islander line. Long shot, just wide. Bounces into center ice. Trottier with it. Ryan Trottier to Bob Bourne, and hit Bossy. Bossy at center ice. Checked on the play, knocked down by Jerry Gillis. And the Islanders force the Rangers back into their own zone. Both teams making player changes. Goring has come out with Gillies and Sutter for the Islanders. Here's Beck into center. Across that Islander line, it was poked off the stick neatly by Lane. This is Vadney. Vadney into center. Turns back at the Ranger line again as he recontrolled the puck to Don Maloney. Now Allison is over the line. Allison to Wallin, and his shot is deflected up into the crowd. We have 9:27 left in regulation time. There's a break in the action with the score. The Islanders 4, the Rangers 1.
This bud's for everyone who works, so we can play.
This bud's for you. For all you do, the king of beers is coming through.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do.
This bud's for you.
Beck on the ice still. I cannot say again. He does not go off very often, Jake. They're getting full mileage from him. Nielsen, 11 against number 11 for the Islanders, Wayne Merrick.
We felt in the two games at the Coliseum that he was playing hurt. Appeared in those two games to have a bad wheel, just a little bit laboring in his skating style. It hasn't been as evident here tonight, 18.
I was going to say he has skated well tonight. It's not evident at all that he is hurting in one of his legs.
Now, Wallin has dug the puck loose, put it out in front. Wide of the Islander goal from the blue line. Vadney around Goring. Vadney winds up, shoots. Smith just got a piece of that. Wayne Merrick jumps it into center. Vadney takes over there. Carroll Vadney being bothered by Goring as he gave it to Beck. Beck shoots it into the far corner. Morty Lane with it. Lane slaps it into center off Goring's stick into the New York Rangers zone. So thus, it'll be called back for icing as Goring was on his own side of the center ice stripe.
Obviously, Al Arbour has instructed his players to ice the puck if you have to. That gentleman is Paul Simon, hockey fan. Didn't realize that is in attendance here. Obviously, I'm sure he's a Ranger fan. Never had a chance to ask him. Talented gentleman.
Yes, he is.
Talking about icing the puck.
You're 2 for 3 tonight in identifying people in the crowd.
Come on, Jiggs. You know I've been around.
I know that, but...
No, I don't mean that way.
Not true. Well, debatable, perhaps.
No, it's not. I'm telling you.
Morrow has cleared the puck, but not out of his own zone. Tom Laidlaw comes in. His drive blocked by Morrow. Henning Morrow covering up on those shots. Now get back of the goal. Comes out in front. Nielsen, and it's grabbed by Billy Smith.
Get the feeling that the Rangers could be moving in closer for another goal here. The Islanders should not be allowing the Rangers to do what they're doing. They're dominating the play in their end of the ice. Sooner or later, from whatever reason, either a good play by the Rangers, a mistake by the Islanders, and they're allowed to get another one. 8:22 remaining here in the third period, 4-1 for the Islanders. But the Rangers have been in this end of the ice, the Islanders' end of the ice, for most of the period. That's 11 minutes and 38 seconds.
Wayne Merrick on the faceoff. Oh, Nielsen got the draw, but it came out into center ice. Laidlaw to Nielsen. Nielsen over to Katsopoulos. To Hedberger, dumps it into the Islanders' zone. Coming back for it is Morrow. Greshner stepped into him. Morrow had it in his skates. Greshner dug it loose around behind the net. Couldn't put it out in front. Now it comes back. Here's Katsopoulos with a shot. Blocked by John Tonelli. Tonelli flipped it into center ice. Nystrom chasing it. Around Laidlaw. Nystrom coming in. Right on goal. His backhander was off the side of the net. He had Baker down, but hit the side of the goal with the backhand.
What a move Bobby Nystrom makes there on Laidlaw, and did not finish the play. He missed the net with the backhand.
And again, Goring forechecking in that Rangers zone as everybody moving around. It comes off the boards, and the Rangers bring it into center, led by Hedberg. Goring chasing him. Hedberg across the line was checked, and Goring clears it to center. Anders Hedberg to Vadney. Carroll Vadney to Duguay. Four Islanders back. Duguay likes to dump one in. Chasing it is Gillies. Around to the right side to Sutter. Deck ran into him with a heavy hit. The puck comes loose. Morrow dumps it out into his own zone to center. Here's Goring on right wing now. Across the Ranger line. Goring pulls to the left. Fed it off in front. Baker knocked that away from Sutter, who had broken in. In center ice, Duguay had trouble picking up the pass from Gillis. Now turns, shoots one in. Billy Smith grabs it. Plays it around the boards. Clark Gillies, Duguay on top of him. Gillies gives it to Langevin back of the net. Dave Langevin up the right side. Sutter pokes it into center. Down into the New York Rangers zone. Vadney being chased by Trottier. Vadney touches up
the net. Hit the side of the net with a backhand. He looked like Guy Lafleur coming down. A right-hand shot off left wing. Again, nice from off left wing. Making some great moves.
Yeah, he has developed something there that the Islanders are certainly getting great mileage out of. This is Beck, number three for the Rangers, to Vadney. Lifted into the center ice zone for Don Maloney. He just backhanded it into the Islander territory. Langevin with it up the left wing side, off Bourne, skates it into center ice. Gary Beck being chased by Trottier. Beck over to Vadney. To Don Maloney. Valine, he was checked at center ice. Vadney chased to the boards by Bossy. Then he ran into Trottier. Don Maloney couldn't control it. This is Mike McEwen. Rink wide to Langevin. Langevin dumps the puck in. We have less than 6 minutes remaining in regulation time. A 4-1 Islander lead. Tuesday night, game four, right here on Sports Channel at 8:30 from Madison Square Garden. Vadney has shot the puck into the Islander zone, but offside is called. 28-18 shots on goal in favor of the Islanders, and that speaks for itself. They allowed the Rangers only 20 shots in game number two, and I think it was 21, if I recall correctly, in the first game of the series.
And the other thing, Jiggs, is that although the Rangers have had the territorial edge by a great margin, they have only had 6 shots in this period so far, which means that the Islanders have covered well. They have not allowed the Rangers to get themselves into a good shooting position. But on the other hand, the Rangers haven't handled the puck. They haven't finished well. One, again, because the Islanders have checked well. But the other thing, the Rangers have not passed the puck well tonight all game long.
Now, Morrow has forced the Rangers into their own zone. This had to be a big game for the Rangers coming into it.
If they were going to win a hockey game from the Islanders and get themselves going, this really had to be the one.
Well, they also had to win everything at home and get a win at the Coliseum to take the series.
Doesn't appear to be. Here's Nystrom again across that Ranger line, again against Laidlaw, makes the play to Tonelli. John Tonelli in front, they score. Wayne Barry tipping in Tonelli's shot, or pass at least, and it's 5-1.
Pretty passing play. The Islanders, who have not had that many chances since Bobby Nystrom went in alone. It's Nystrom again who gets the play underway with some fine hustle by Bob Nystrom against who else but number two, Tom Laidlaw. Laidlaw got a lick on the puck. He didn't get enough of it. And here's the pass. Bobby Nystrom to John Tonelli. Look where Merrick is, all alone. Merrick, all he has to do is guide the puck. And that's Kasopoulos, number 24, that was going after it. Here's John Tonelli's pass. There's Wayne Merrick's tip-in. Greschner could not get back to him in time. The Rangers, of course, saw everybody up the ice trying to get a goal, and that's the price you have to pay sometimes when you open up trying to get back into a hockey game. The Islanders consistently now in three games have taken advantage of almost every mistake that the Rangers have made.
Merrick from Tonelli and Nystrom at 14:54 is the goal. Billy Smith just came up with a save on Gillis. Puck cleared out of there, but held in. Beck trying to set up Talifas on the right wing. Back of the goal to Gillis. Gillis checked by Billy Carroll. Here's Vadney in from the point. Ran into Lane. The puck loose. Controlled by Lorimer. Bob Lorimer dumps it into center. Down the ice into the Rangers zone. That's going to be brought back on an icing call as Talifas touches up. There's a break in the action with 4:17 left in regulation time, and the score, the New York Islanders 5, the New York Rangers 1. Collegiate baseball returns to Sports Channel tomorrow when the Red Men of St. John's University play host to the Columbia Lions. You can catch that action starting at 4:30 here on Sports Channel. And then on Monday night at 7, Columbia against the University of Pennsylvania. Don't miss any of the exciting collegiate baseball action here on Sports Channel. Sports Channel, your box seat to New York sports at home.
.417 left in this hockey game. Now 5-1, the New York Islanders on a pretty goal, pretty passing play, Wayne Merrick.
Quick shot, and Smith, a good save. That was Valine again, who was open for the Rangers. At center ice, Katsopoulos sends Maloney over the line. Maloney to Allison on the backhand. He was chased to the corner by Langevin. Now up to Laidlaw. Shot blocked in front. Smith, a diving save as he covered up. Maloney was there. And a pileup just inside the blue line. Langevin gets up a little slowly after he and Allison had gone to the deck. But Billy Smith came up with another good save.
You can always tell when someone has missed an assignment. When you see Dave Langevin out almost at the blue line, he's tied up with Mike Allison. He should not be out there. Wayne Merrick banging his stick on the ice like he had missed a check and allowed Allison to get the shot away. Langevin might have been covering for Wayne Merrick.
Now the Rangers get the draw. Laidlaw shot, Smith the save, and Langevin is there to feed it to Bourne and out of Merrick at center. Wayne Merrick turning, lost control of it, plays it back to Langevin, to McEwen on the right side. Mike McEwen falling as he got the puck to Bourne. Bourne checked in the center ice zone. Here's Don Maloney for the Rangers. Again, he dumps it into the corner, the far side of the ice. Langevin back. Langevin played it around the boards. Maloney knocked it down, put it out in front. Allison's shot was blocked before he could get it away. Bob Bourne up the left side to Carroll. Billy Carroll flips it into the Rangers zone. Baker out of the net to knock it away from Bossy. Bad day back. He just dumps the puck into the center ice zone. And he pops and picks it up with a little more than 3 minutes to go in regulation time. Here's Morrow to Gillies. Mark Gillies shot it in off Beck. Vadney in the far corner carries it back of the Ranger goal. It's Sutter, Goring, and Gillies for the Islanders as Potvin chases the puck back into his own zone. Potvin upended from behind, no whistle. Greschner with it, back to Barry Beck. Beck fired one that just went wide. Morrow pulled it away from it. It went wide on the glove side of Smith. Rangers trying to put it out. Hedberg was checked by Morrow. Now Greschner with it. Greschner with Goring watching him. Greschner put it out in front. Nilsson couldn't get a stick on it. Here comes Gillies with 2.5 minutes left. Mark Gillies shooting it into the Rangers zone. Wayne Sutter in after it. He and Beck collide on the boards. Rangers played around the boards. Held in by Goring from the blue line. A shot. Baker the save. Hedberg.
Lead pass to Wolf Nielsen. Goring stepped in front of him. Nielsen picked it up again. Sends Vadney over the blue line. Vadney dumps one into the corner. Wayne Sutter is there. Sutter around the boards on the open wing. Here's Laidlaw from the blue line. He shoots through a screen. Blocked in front. Poked at by Smith. And Merrick is there to cover up. Wayne Merrick, who's seen an awful lot of ice time tonight, has dumped the puck to center and on into the Rangers zone. A minute 55 left in regulation time. 5-1 Islander lead. Gillies sends Duguay through the defense. He was checked. Gillies again for the Rangers. Back of the goal. They try to put it out in front. Duguay was there, but he couldn't make it lie down. Now Laidlaw with a shot. Smith the save. Duguay poking at the rebound. It comes out in front, but underneath Billy Smith. There's a break in the action with the score.
Powered the Rangers here again in game three.
They have not won in this building in regular season play the last two seasons. They come up with a fine effort here tonight. And we'll take a 3-0 lead in this best of seven semifinal series. A chance to eliminate the Rangers in straight games on Tuesday night. This is Merrick into center ice to Nystrom. Ian Tonelli over the line. Nystrom trying to come in on the right wing this time. Taken to the boards by Katsopoulos. It got away from him. Bobby Nystrom back at the Ranger line. Gave it to Tonelli. Tonelli's pass into the corner to Merrick. Merrick out in front. Tonelli coming in around the check. The side of the goal to Nystrom. And Baker made a good save off Bob Nystrom. Into center is Duguay. Right side for Talifas. Talifas going around behind the net with it. Out in front. Barry Beck winds up. His shot blocked by Billy Smith. Duguay battling for the rebound with McEwen. It comes to the boards. Barry Beck can't get around Merrick. Now Beck with it again, put it off to the side of the goal. It was cleared by Langevin. Wayne Merrick steps in front of Beck. They fight for it along the boards. It came out in front of the Islander goal to Tonelli with 24 seconds left. Here's Andy Kallur across the line. Couldn't get around Vadney. Vadney into center ice. Carroll Vadney trying to make the play. Valine with it for the Rangers. Couldn't control it as he tried to move around Lorimer, and the Islanders have dumped it to center. 6 seconds left. Vadney slaps it off the boards to Beck, and that's going to do it. Barry Beck at center ice. Take the long shot. There's the buzzer. Billy Smith raises his arm in the victory salute. And the Islanders have defeated the Rangers at Madison Square Garden to take a 3-0 lead in the series. A big victory. Game four is here on Tuesday night. The final scores, the New York Islanders 5, the New York Rangers 1.